Raymond Boots Riley is an outspoken activist and renowned hip-hop artist. He's the frontman and producer of The Coup, as well as the frontman for Street Sweeper Social Club, along with guitarist Tom Morello from Rage Against the Machine. His passion and his politics have gained him recognition around the world. And yesterday, he took time out of the recording studio to talk to RT. I asked him his thoughts on everything from music to police brutality to capitalism to President Obama. Here's part of that conversation. Does President Obama represent real change from, for example, the previous president, President George W. Bush?
No, he doesn't represent real change. Unfortunately, the reason that he got elected is that people thought that he was representing real change. Even though he did not say he was going to end the war, people elected him because they thought that he would end the war. I don't know why, but that's basically what happened. He got elected with a mandate to end the war. He did not do it. And as a matter of fact, we've got more bombings on Pakistan now than we ever did under George Bush's rule. You know, that's already happening. The Iraq war doesn't seem to be in. We're not pulling out right now, and we keep being told it's going to be later. And we're sending more troops to Afghanistan. All the hopes and dreams of everyone with seeing that there's a black president and, you know, put in, it's really just like we got a black manager at McDonald's, and all the workers at McDonald's are happy, thinking that everything's going to be different. But no, you still got to get your ass in front of that cash register. And you're still going to have to sweep and mop the floors just as hard. And really, you're going to still get paid the same exact amount, although you got a new, handsome black manager at McDonald's. You know, that's just how it's going down.
Did you, Boots, think that, you know, 2 years ago when he first came, did you think that he would actually change things? No?
No, no, no. I mean, I know that power is not about the elected officials. Power under capitalism is about the ruling class. The elected officials are just puppets of the ruling class. So what we elect is who we want to be the next puppet. You know, the seat of power in the world is with the people that own the means of production, with the people that own, you know, the corporations that are running the world. We see, like, you know, there's certain amounts of evidence, hardcore evidence that came out, for instance, during the last administration, during the Bush administration, which was that basically Enron sat down and wrote out energy policy. Just wrote it out. Here's the energy policy. Boom, do that. That's the same sorts of thing, the sort of things that are going on around other policy. And we are, you know, so that's where the power is. The person that can write that memo and shove it over to the president, that's who's creating the policy.
And wondering if you see democratic socialism as a viable alternative to capitalism.
Well, I believe we should have real democracy. I believe that real democracy is not just people electing officials that are supposed to represent you. I believe that real democracy are the people having democratic control over the profits they create. And that means you can call it communism, you can call it socialism, you can call it, you know, whatever you want to call it, but that's what we need. And so my answer would be yes. I think that people need control over their lives, and they need control over the things that surround them, you know.
I want to talk a little bit about police brutality, about how kind of ironic and interesting, or perhaps not interesting it is, that police cannot be taped. What do you think about this, the rules that are still in place to protect these actions despite them coming to light?
It's the police and the power that they protect showing us that they really don't care, that that they're not even going to act like they care, not even going to give a semblance of the need for justice around these issues.
And finally, I want to talk about music. Music and politics, of course, were intertwined in the 60s. Not so much today. It seems like we're not kind of seeing some of the movements that we saw back then today. What do you think happened to music as a political force?
We had decades of the civil rights movement going on. We had the Black Power movement. We had the anti-war movement. And those songs came from there. It wasn't the other way around. We don't have those movements happening right now.